Herman Mudgett, a.k.a. H.H. Holmes, was hanged in Philadelphia at Moyamensing Prison, 1896. I was born with the devil in me. I was born with the evil one standing as my sponsor beside the bed where I was ushered into this world. And he's been with me ever since. In 1893, Chicago, Illinois was host to a spectacular world fair, the Columbian Exposition, a celebration of Columbus's discovery of America. Unfortunately, at the end of the fair, people had vanished, and the trail to their whereabouts turned cold on the south side of Chicago. A devil that became known as America's first real serial killer, luring unsuspecting visitors to the hotel where they vanished without a trace, never to be seen again.
Mommy? 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 Mommy, please leave Cassie. Cassie, come. Come now, baby. Come here. No, Cassie, don't go with her. Cassie, come back. Cassie. Cassie.
Cassie.
me.
Nothing. She was trying to sell me something, but you remember to stay away from strangers.
She's always trying to sell mommy's prayers too, but she just say no thank you.
And just you remember to do the same thing. People may say many things, but you're trusting yourself and God. Everything else doesn't matter. Now get in the car.
How many times I done told you, you can't scare me. I'm the big daddy. Nothing scares the big daddy.
Right, that's why you almost dropped it. So what's this? Victim number 9 or 10, right?
Yep.
You know, I'm so tired of this pervert killing our people.
Let's see, these are some great shots. You know, brother had to work a little of his magic, but they came out good as perfect.
Yeah, they are. I could have done better.
Oh, yeah? And how so?
Oh, okay. Well, look. A decent photographer, Shawnee, captured the strength and the integrity of the murder scene.
Yeah, I mean, but it's still a good shot.
Yeah, it's all right. Stop it, you freak. Where's everybody at?
Well, let's see. You know, Jackie took her butt home early.
Mm-hmm, that figures.
And Miss Faye just left for a meeting.
Right.
So that means it's just you and me, all alone in this, this dark room.
Don't start tonight, little boy. Chris, I can't sleep. My nightmares are getting worse. My granny's getting old. You know, Cassie accidentally fumbled over some of these pictures the other day. How do you explain that to an 8-year-old? You know, she wants to know why I take these photos. I just wish these killings would just stop.
Look, this shit would never stop, Tina. I mean, look at it like this. He's keeping us a job, right?
Tina, Chris, Miss Faye is here.
Miss Faye, look, I think I need to take some time off from this. This is driving me insane.
Tina, I only have 2 photographers. You and the other one is on vacation. Now, let's face it, he's getting a little too old for this. Nobody takes pictures like you do. You're good at what you do, you're a go-getter. And I admit, sometimes we're gonna run a little risk. But baby, that's the beauty in this.
There's nothing beautiful about murders.
Tina, I need you, okay? If you need to take a day off, take a day off. But the murders can't go on forever, okay?
Yeah. Tina.
Tina.
I can't believe it.
Tina.
Can't believe
my
that.
Baby girl.
What happened?
Oh,
What's going on?
Oh.
We're trying so hard to make things better.
What?
And it just
I just sweat.
I missed you.
Yeah, I missed you too. Come on, let's go get in our own bed. Come.
Alright.
Come on, baby. So, what did you and Grandma do today?
Grandma read me stories from the Bible.
Really? That's great. Do you remember which story?
Yep, it was about a great man named Job.
I think you mean Job.
Ah, that's right. It was Job.
Do you want me to read you a story?
Yes.
Really? What kind?
A scary story.
Now, Cassie, you haven't been watching those scary movies, have you? What did I tell you about scary things?
That all give me bad nightmares.
Right. And I don't want my baby having bad nightmares.
Okay, Mom.
No more stories tonight.
Mwah.
Love you. I love you.
Love you too.
All right.
God is good, God is great. God is love, God never hates. God loves you and God loves me. God loves harmony and God loves peace. God bless my mommy, my granny, and Mousy.
Savagely mutilated and left for trash inside of this abandoned building.
The recent killings have plagued the community of Inglewood for the last 20 years. Authorities describe the man as Monzel Huntington, a man with a heartless lifestyle, bringing the killer's number to 10, but more importantly, he was a human being.
More importantly, he was a human being.
Shut up, stupid. I mean, why you tripping, man? I like old girl.
Man, you like it because you want to fuck her, that's all.
I mean, yeah, that too. But I'm saying, though, man, the show is not that bad, you know what I'm saying? She kicked the real shit, and that's what I like, the real.
What's real? Show, what's real?
The Inglewood killer, dog.
Inglewood killer, man. You sound like my little sister.
So?
She only 9 years old.
Look, bruh. I don't give a damn if your sister was 9 months. This Inglewood nigga going around raping and slicing up girls, man. You better open your eyes. This shit is real.
Man, you scared.
I ain't never scared, homie.
Hey, no more TV for you, homie.
Yeah, whatever.
What the hell? That sound like her. Crazy ass.
Yeah, probably another one of his crazy ass dreams, man. Yo. I thought they was gonna move him up out of here.
I thought they was gonna move him out of here too. Hey, it's about that time, dude. You get the rest of them nuts, I'm gonna get hurt, dude.
All right.
What you yelling about, Herman? Why is it so cold over here all the time?
This, what the hell? It's supposed to be light.
Yo, Clarence! Did you open Herman's cave?
It's supposed to be closed. When? Fuck is
it? Man, this damn job is not worth this. Where's this crazy mother? Shit. Herman! Herman!
Man, quit playing, damn!
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Chris, what do you notice about all these photos?
I don't know. They all dead.
That was not funny.
I'm just kidding. I don't know. I mean, what?
Okay, look. You see how they're all facing the ground? You know, like face down?
You know, you're right.
Tina, Miss Faye had me page you 911. You will not believe who she's meeting with.
Who?
Dorothy Holmes, the alderwoman. And she wants to meet with us, too.
What do you think is going on?
Girl, I haven't the slightest idea, but she wants those photos pronto. Oh, remember, sweetie, I get first dibs on any inside scoop, okay?
I will meet you in there.
All right, girl. Lay off the coffee.
I'll see you inside.
Okay.
Wow. Alderman, huh? Must be nice.
Just telling the ladies, I like how you organize the new layout. The photos are truthful, and the stories are informative. Our people need that, especially in Englewood. You know, my great-grandmother took a walk to the local pharmacy in Englewood. She disappeared just like that. No one knew what happened. No one really cared back then. I remember when this used to be a nice neighborhood. I was raised in Englewood all my life. Half of my family's history plagues these streets. I'm gonna do everything I can to clean it up. Your eyes are the mirrors of your soul. You remember that, okay, ladies? Now you ladies take care. And Miss Faye, I will see you at church.
So, Miss Faye, what's going on?
You know that strange building off the expressway over there? That building used to be an old Catholic monastery built back in 1868. But now it's a
privately funded institution for the mentally insane. What about it?
Sounds scary.
Last night, one of the attendants that worked the graveyard shift was murdered. And the other one's face was badly burned. Tina, I'm actually going to put someone else on this case.
What?
No. Okay?
I can do it.
Why? Because of what happened to my mother? I'm over this.
Tina, you do know who's still inside this place, don't you?
I don't care. I can handle this. I want this case.
I can't have you girls bringing me any more trouble, okay? You're good at what you do, but you're not that good. Now, Dorothy was kind enough to grant us access to this case. Tina, no more crossing any police lines. You are not a cop. It's illegal. Okay.
I don't care. I can handle this. I want this case.
Chicago Mental Asylum. You guys know that place is supposed to be under lock and key, right? I mean, no reporter has ever been allowed in there. So, Tina, why didn't she want you to go?
That's not important, okay? But I am so ready for this assignment.
Yeah, okay. I heard it was some straight-up crazy people in there.
You know, this could be your big television break, Miss Jackie. Think about it.
He's right, you know. So, when do we get to go?
Tomorrow afternoon.
Tina. There's something else bothering you. Don't forget I know you, okay? Remember, you are my best friend. Talk to me. I can be a bitch sometimes, but I'm here for you. What's wrong?
Do you remember what happened to my mother?
Of course. She was killed.
Right.
Why? What does that have to do with this?
The guy who did it is in there.
Oh my God. Are you sure?
I'm positive. Promise me you won't tell Granny. You know, she's already spooky, and she will freak out if she finds out about this.
Tina, I swear your life would make a great story. I'm talking Pulitzer Prize win. What? I'm joking. I'm just playing.
Playing about what?
Nothing. What are you doing tomorrow?
Why? Are you considering asking him to go with us? Please, we don't need him.
No brother thought about shooting a little hoops, watching the game, you know, man stuff. Tomorrow's my day off. Why? You planning on hanging out with a brother or something?
Maybe. We can maybe do something. If you come with me to the assignment.
Where to? Hope not that crazy house. Let's see. Crazy house, Bulls versus the Lakers. Tina, Bulls versus the Lakers. It's gotta be the game.
Your loss. Am I really prepared for this? I want to see this man. Some help?
Nah, I got this.
You got this?
For shizzle my nizzle.
All right then. What's up, Grandma?
Hey, baby girl.
Man, I saw this weirdest white guy just walking down the street today. Yo, those brothers gonna trip when they see him.
How did he look?
Ma'am?
How did he look?
Don't even much worry about it. It's not important. It's not even important. Don't even worry about it. Is that ringing that doorbell?
Who is that? Duane!
Ringing this doorbell. You. Why do you keep on ringing the doorbell? Nothing. Now, you know that scares Grandma.
I mean, I forgot.
Mom, you can't forget. It's so simple.
Okay, I'm sorry.
You can't be doing that, for real. I gotta live with her. You don't.
Okay, I forgot. All right. Now, where's she at? Hey, Grandma. What's going on? My baby, what's up, little G? What's going on?
Hey, don't be teaching my daughter that thug lingo.
It's better than me than them other niggas. I'm sure what's going on in these streets for real.
I think she'll be just fine without that type of language.
You've been smoking that reefer. You got my whole house smelling like that stuff.
Grandma, that ain't no reefer. That's the Holy Spirit that's all over my body. And look, just let me know when the food is ready, all right? I'm gonna be out front, okay? Hello? Hey, what's up? What's up, gangster? Chillin'? What? Hold on, man. Hold on for a minute. Hold on. You straight, little cuz?
Word, cuz.
That's what's up, baby.
Oh, you think that's funny, huh? Huh? Come here, you little monster.
Girl, what's up?
Girl, did you do that yet?
No, I'm just waiting on Montana to get back from the store.
I'm tired.
Hell, me too.
Did you call him?
No, I ain't called that nigga.
You still mad?
Yep. Yeah, I went to class today, so where was your trifling ass?
I was at school.
Well, I ain't see you.
I was there.
Where were you?
In the backseat of Donnie's car.
You are so nasty. You know that paper on serial killers is due Friday, right?
Yeah. Who you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing mine on this crazy-ass white man named Dr. Death.
Why him?
I heard he was from here. I got some more research to do. What about you?
Girl, I'm doing Jack the Ripper.
Jack the Ripper? Yuck.
Father!
You know what?
Hello?
Let me call you back, all right?
Alicia?
No, it's cool. Let me call you
What's
back.
What's wrong?
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir. Are you all right? Hello?
911.
No, I'm sorry, I didn't call you. It was a mistake.
Ma'am? Are you sure you didn't call?
Yeah, I'm sure. Thank you.
Okay.
I'm sorry, but you are beyond your God's help. You cannot stop me.
Al-Muhaymin, Al-Muhaymin, Al-Muhaymin.
So it is.
Thank you.
Asylum and no asylum.
I can't believe I'm missing the game for this. This place looks closed.
I guess that's the idea. Chris, before we go inside, do you remember what I told you about my mother?
Yeah, I do. Why?
He's in here.
Who's in here?
My mother's killer.
Here? He's in this building.
Gosh, calm down. You're gonna wake the dead.
Come on, y'all. We are not going in here. I'll tell Miss Faye myself.
Why are you tripping?
Tripping? Her mother's killer is in this building. Did you or did you not just hear that?
Yeah, so?
It's all right, okay? All right? I'm over it. I'm fine. I'm gonna do this, okay?
Hey, if you say so.
She says so, all right? Follow me, Casanova.
Yes. Hi, I'm from a street scene newspaper. I'm a photographer, and they call me Miss Tina Moore.
Hi, Jackie Collins, writer with Street Scene. Pleased to meet you.
Miss Faye, the director of Street Scene, she said that you would know why we're here.
I don't know any Miss Faye, dear. I'm sorry, I can't help.
Wait, no. The alderman sent us. You know what? Here, see, got a card.
Dorothy Holmes. How do you know her?
She's my aunt, okay? She set this whole thing up. Listen, we know about the murder. Yeah, so how many people do you think would know about that?
All right, come on in. Never mind the other people already here. I guess they got special privileges, too.
Look, how long are we gonna be here?
Just chill out, all right? Not too long.
Fact or fiction? I'm getting a real story. All right, Herman Mudgett Jr., where are you? Channel 5 awaits. Okay, Jackie, get it together, girl. You're a professional. Do this. I am in the Chicago Asylum for the Criminally Insane, where a body has been found mutilated. Another victim of the Inglewood killer.
Thank you. That'll be all we need.
Good.
Okay?
Can we clean this place up now? It's starting to stink.
She's all yours. So what are you doing here?
My job.
Some fucking job you got.
Excuse you?
You heard me. Some fucking job you got.
Listen here, okay? My mother was killed 25 years ago. I moved on. Maybe it's time for you to. You don't be talking to me like that.
I hope she's great.
The attendant's name was Thomas Dixon. He was 26 years old. I found him lying face down in his own blood, right in the middle of this hallway. Right over there where the blood is. Seems like he was dragged, but we don't know the reason for the spaces.
Why was he here?
Detective Granbury? He's always here. He arrested a man named Herman a long time ago. The Englewood serial killings, that's his case. He likes to watch Herman.
Herman, is he in here?
Oh, yes, his cage is right around the corner there.
Hey, look, I told you, we don't have to do this. Let's go.
Chris, I'm okay.
You know, somehow I just don't think that this is a good idea. It's too weird.
Chris.
Let's go.
Chris, I'm fine.
I'm a big girl. I can handle myself.
Friends are people who say they love you, or buy you gifts, and read you good stories at night like my mommy. My mommy is my best friend in the whole wide world.
My great-grandma says that she does not want me to die like my mommy's mom.
Cassie, what are you saying? Cassie, who are you looking at?
A friend.
I don't see anyone, sweetie. Who is it?
I don't know her name.
Well, does she scare you?
No, she's a nice lady.
Okay, Cassie. Are you okay? Are you okay? Cassie. Cassie.
Jr., one of Englewood's many serial killers. He doesn't communicate. He only talks to his mother, who calls him Hermy Jr. That detective brought him here.
It's cold in here. Tina?
Oh, not to worry. He's harmless now. His brain barely functions.
What about the other attendant? What happened to him?
The attacker threw some acid in his face, blinding him. It also dissolved his tongue. He's in a coma now at University of Chicago. I guess the killer didn't want him to die.
Can you make him come closer?
Sometimes, I guess if he's in the mood. Hey, where's your friend?
Yeah, where is Jackie?
Let's go back upstairs.
Is everything okay?
I'm all right, Chris. Wait up.
Let's get out of here.
Hello? Is anybody there? Tina? Chris? Who's there? Please, this isn't funny, guys. This is not a joke. Who's out there? Can anybody hear me? Who is that?
Anything else, dear?
Oh, thank you. No thanks. You've been of great help.
Thank you. Pleasure's all mine. Just be sure and tell the alderman about my good deed.
Sound like Jackie.
Where the hell is she? What is she doing?
So, what did you see there?
I don't know, Chris. Something. Okay, you guys don't believe me. All right, well, listen to this. Wait a minute, just... You know what? Just pull over. I'll take the bus home, Chris. Pull over!
See you tomorrow. What's going on?
Cassie isn't here.
What?
Cassie's not here.
What do you mean she's not here?
We can't.
Where is she at?
I don't know.
Where's Grandma at?
At the house, man. I don't know.
Don't worry. We gonna find her, all right? We gonna find cuz.
Don't do nothing stupid.
We gonna find her. Fuck that.
Where's my daughter? Huh? I saw you looking earlier. Okay? Now my daughter's gone. Where is she?
I don't have your daughter. And if you'd like to come in, yes. I can help you find Cassie.
How the hell you know my daughter's name? You don't know us. Huh? I'm calling the cops.
I don't have your daughter, Dina. But I can help you find her. You just have to trust me.
I don't gotta do shit. Okay, and why should I trust you? Why? What?
Think I'm a crazy lady?
Yeah.
That's fine.
But you know, that which is seen on the outside isn't necessarily what's on the inside. I'm here because of you and your family. Please. Please. Come in. Tina, what I'm about to tell you will either scare you or run you away. It'll be your choice. Most people just run away scared and do exactly the opposite of what I've instructed. But I can help you find Cassie.
Who are you?
My name is Basima. I'm a soul warrior of sorts, spiritual sentry between this world and the dark side. Do you believe, Tina?
Believe in what?
Faith, hope, destiny, good, evil.
Listen here, Basima. I don't know what you're getting at. Okay, but I'll do anything to get my daughter. What do you want? You want money?
No.
Or what? What are you doing?
Listen. The demon feeds off fear. I know it's hard, but you'll have to try to relax. And you'll have to try to trust me. I can use your energy to find Cassie. So just relax. This is how I use my gift. Spiritual intervention has brought you and I together. So please, let the spirits use me to help you.
Where is she?
I don't know. Your past is linked to the demon in the Inglewood area, a killer like no other before, a killer demon.
Is this the Inglewood killer?
The demon I see has no face.
Why my daughter, not me? Okay? I'll do anything to get her. You know, what do I have to do? Just tell me what I have to do and I'll do it.
You have to go see an old woman in Wilmette. And that's where you'll get your answers. Keep your friend behind you and the man with the shield beside you. Make sure she tells you about the man you saw the other day. Make sure she tells you. Find out what happened. And finish it. You have to go now. But remember to have faith. God bless you, Tina.
That, G?
Just leaving a message, man, for my cousin, Tina. This is so fucked up, man.
Man, look, we gonna get your cousin back, G, on the boss. We gonna get your little cousin back. Straight up.
I'm ready to take a piss.
All right.
Some sent-off shit, G. Thought we don't even know who this the fuck we looking for, dude. Big crazy white man, white lady, dude. Can't be a nigga gone mad like the sniper, folks.
I know it, man, but you know D Good, that's our partner, dog, and we gotta stay out here until we find him, you know? Fuck it, man.
Shit, gravy, fam.
I'm just ready to murk this nigga, dog. Get back on my grind. Probably give me some pussy, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, this shit crazy, man. I mean, dude out here murdering the pussy. I mean, I beat up the pussy. But dude out here stabbing the pussy, man. He mutilating the pussy up, and I don't understand this shit.
What you think be making niggas do this shit, G?
I don't know, man. I think motherfuckers might be possessed or... I don't know, but I mean, last month they caught a black dude, man. They called him the Inglewood serial killer, you know what I mean?
Hey, yo, ain't that Duane?
Yo, what the fuck is he doing?
Come on, man. That nigga chasing something, man.
Yo, you done wrestled with the wrong fucking family now, nigga. You gonna get my cousin back, motherfucker. I'm sick of this shit. Where the fuck you at? Huh? You wanna mess with little girls now, nigga, huh? Come on. Come on.
Damn, shit is mad.
Yeah, okay. I don't know, but I'm telling you, I'ma shoot and ask questions later.
Listen.
Bring your bitch ass out here! Face a real motherfucking gangster. Take me instead, you fucking coward. It's our nigga land right here.
Dog, the police is coming, dude. You know what the fuck gonna happen when they find out we did this shit, dog?
Man, it's our guy. We can't leave him here like this, man.
So what we gonna do, G? Fuck it. Give him them guns, dog. Let me hide them, dude.
Excuse me. Attention, everybody. All right, everybody, calm down. Thank you for coming, and thank you for your patience. My name is Officer Paul Granberry. I'm with the Chicago Police Department Detective Division. We've been doing some diligent work as far as trying to calm the area and get things under control. Do you have any questions?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I want to know is what y'all gonna do about all that shooting that's going over there on Halsted, huh?
What we've done about the shootings in Halsted is we have actually increased our patrolmen over there. We also have added more detectives in the area so that our presence isn't as noticed and we can apprehend the people who are actually doing the harm over there, as you would have it. Next question.
Sure. How many Inglewood serial killers are there?
There are 7 Inglewood serial killers that we know of. A lot of the killings that we have found out have been gang-related, and it's not necessarily related to a serial killer. So, yes, there are 7 that we do know of.
When are y'all gonna catch this Inglewood killer?
Oh, that sir, thank you for asking that question, but just for a little clarification, the Inglewood killer is a myth. It's just a fairy tale. Now, if you had said killers in Inglewood, that would be a different thing. There are killings in Inglewood, but no killers as far as a killer named the Inglewood Killer. It's just a myth. But we have done everything we could, and with your help and the CAPS program, you keeping an eye out. We can't be everywhere all the time. You have to help us look out. And if you see anything that's strange or out of the ordinary, please don't hesitate to call. There is no retaliation.
Tina needs to see you downstairs.
Thank you. So, if there's nothing else, I am going to have to leave you guys. But my name is Officer Paul Granberry, Detective Division. So if you have any more questions, feel free to call me. Thank you.
Paul, I need you to help me. Cassie is gone, okay? She's missing. She didn't come home from school today.
Are you sure she's missing or she's...
Look, Cassie is gone, okay? She did not come home from school today.
Come on, calm down. It's only been a couple hours, okay?
Look.
Is this a prayer or something?
Fasima, okay?
The crazy lady?
Yes. Basima said that there's this lady out in Wilmette, this old lady, that can help me find Cassie. She knows about the Inglewood killer, and she can help me find my daughter.
Oh, wait a minute. There's no such thing as an Inglewood killer. That's just a myth, Tina. It's just a fairy tale. Now, there is a killer out there, but his M.O. is not little girls.
So the police department is just going to turn its back on me like it did 25 years ago when my mother was murdered? What, you're gonna blame it on gangs, right? Well, my mother was not murdered by a gang.
How dare you do that? I lost just as much as you when your mother was killed, and I was there. I saw everything. Don't throw that in my face. I've always been there for you since she's died. Always been there. Like the time I got you in on a crime scene to do your own investigation on your mother, which damn near cost me my job. Don't tell me I hadn't been there for you, girl.
Paul, look, I just don't want the same thing to happen to Cassie that happened to my mother. Will you please help me?
All right, I'll tell you what. Look, I'll put out an APB, have some guys ride around, see if they can find her. If they do, then we'll call. She'll probably be home before you get there. But in the meantime, you got that, any more information on that lady in Wilmette?
Yes, I have the address. It's 666 Terry Brown Road.
Okay. If she's not home by tomorrow, I'll go by there and take a look, okay?
Okay.
All right. All right. You go home. Take it easy, okay? Just calm down. Calm down. It'll be okay. Just calm down. We'll find her. All right? Six 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 Terry Brown Road. I know that address.
Church when you get this message. Praying with the missionaries. God only knows what's going on here. Remember that God works in mysterious ways, but he will deliver our baby from the evil one. And he won't get Cassie. He won't get her. I'll be in church all night, so call me if you need me. I'm at 773-737-0747.
So is everything okay?
God bless.
It's okay. Granny's at church praying.
That's good. You know, my mother say prayer always works.
Wait, do you really have to go?
I'm crazy about you, Tina. And I just don't want you to think that I'm trying to take advantage of you because of all this, you know?
Mm-hmm.
See you tomorrow.
I don't take my blood pressure medicine. I don't need no damn Viagra. Cheers.
Hey. You off duty, young man?
Look, why don't you mind your own damn business?
You think you big and bad enough to make me?
What's up with you, boy? Hey, man, how you doing?
Look at you. So what brings you back to my place? You
must have another difficult case.
Actually, I'm on vacation, young fellas.
You're right. What's the matter, Paul? You look worried.
Yep, just like you, Ty. You're always straight to the point, huh? You guys believe in ghosts?
Oh, shit.
No. You know I'm an atheist.
You still hating God for what happened?
Not hate. Just mad, that's all.
That doesn't make you an atheist, buddy.
Touch my hat again, we be knocking down chairs and pool tables. This must be serious.
Yeah. Little girl was kidnapped the other day. You remember Alicia Moore?
Yeah.
It's her granddaughter.
Oh. Man, I'm sorry. How is this your case? You're on vacation.
Well, I was talking to her mother the other day, and she just didn't want to deal with any other cops or with any other cops.
Paul, man, you don't need to be involved in this thing anymore. You know exactly where this is going to lead to.
Man, I'm already involved.
Yeah, but Paul, come on, man. You know better. Don't do this to yourself or to your career again.
Look, it's different this time, guys. It's different this time. Look, I didn't bring you guys here for pessimism. All I want is some support. Come on, give me a, touch me up, huh?
Yeah,
all right.
Whatever.
You late on that one. Come on, give me some. All right.
You know, Paul, I really do believe in ghosts. I had a weird experience once.
Listen, I gotta take care of some. I'll be right back. Take it easy. You're on vacation. Not chasing niggas or ghosts, okay?
So did you ever see a ghost?
What is wrong with you, man? I've never seen you like this before.
It's something about this, man. Something feels like it's just pulling me in, you know?
That's Jill. I gotta go.
Speaking of ghosts,
do yourself a favor. Leave the White City. Go get you some sunshine. You look so pale as a crayon shade. Take your vacation.
I will. Oh, you too.
That's what friends are for. Hey, sweetie, touch me up again.
Hey,
what's up, Jackie?
Just got off the phone with Tina. She's in bed. God, I can't believe all this is happening to her. It's like her family's cursed or something, you know?
What do you know about this Inglewood killer? Do you believe what the kids talk about?
I don't know. I mean, the kids say he's not real, you know? So I just treat it like any other myth or fairy tale.
I know, but what if he is real? Tina thinks he's real. She thinks he has Cassie.
God, Chris. I don't know. Well, look. If he is real, then he can be caught. But according to the kids, he can't be caught, so he's...
What?
He's not real. He's a fictional character. He's not like John Wayne Gacy or Ted Bundy or somebody.
What did you see at the asylum?
I couldn't see anything, Chris. But I felt it. Something. Somebody was there. Somebody was watching me. I'm telling the truth. I'll never go back to that place again. Be careful, okay? I'll talk to you later.
Tina, it's Paul. Look, I need to talk to you.
Can I help you?
Yes. Yes, hi. My name is Tina Moore, and this is Chris Jones.
How do you do?
Look, you want to try this another time, Tina?
No, I'm fine. I'm fine. We live in Chicago. I live in the Englewood area. Have you heard of it?
Yes, my child, I'm quite familiar with the neighborhood of Englewood.
Look,
but what can I do for you?
I want to try this another time.
No, I'm okay.
Oh, dear child, no tears now. Please come in. I'll get you a soft cloth. It'll help.
Thank you. Thank you. Look, I'm sorry about that.
Oh, no apologies necessary, my dear, but what brings you so far from home?
My daughter was kidnapped the other day from school.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry. Is there anything I can do, sweetheart?
Are you the missus of the house?
I am.
Please, I was sent to ask you about the Englewood killer.
Oh, dear. I haven't heard that name in over 25 years, since I took my son away and put him in that awful place. How did you get my address? Who sent you here, if I may ask?
Her name is Basema. She's a spiritual advisor, and she told me that you would have the answer.
The answers to what?
Him, the Englewood killer.
Oh, Tina, you should be careful of people like that. They're hypocrites and evil liars. Listen, sweetheart, I sympathize with you about your daughter. I really do. I suffer the same way you do, every day, day in and day out. I, too, have had family members taken from me by powers I don't know or understand. Look, I don't know how my family is connected to your missing little girl, but I'll tell you what I do know. I'll tell you what I know about the man your people call the Englewood killer. It's so hard keeping the past in the past when people keep resurrecting it. This curse has haunted my family for a long and difficult time. My husband's father was the first serial killer in America. He was from the neighborhood of Englewood. His real name was Holmes, although he used many aliases. This was my husband. He was a doctor over at the LaSalle Medical Center. He died in 1975. And here is my son on his 18th birthday. There are many stories about my father-in-law. One in particular about his burial. A tall tale. Maybe this is what your advisor was talking about. After he was executed for his crimes, 13 men went to lower his coffin. They buried him face down, facing hell. Now the story goes that if any one of the 13 men's family members turn him over and free his trapped soul, he will remove his curse from their descendants.
I don't know what this has to do with me finding my daughter, but I'll do anything to get her. I'm scared. I miss her.
Well, I can imagine.
So what you're trying to tell me is if I turn this man over, my little girl will be returned back to me?
That's the tale.
This seems so unreal. I can't believe this. But you know what? Forget it. I don't care. How do I get there?
Granny's at church. She'll be here soon.
I can't believe this stuff is happening in my neighborhood. I mean, it's just so unbelievable.
Y'all think it could be the same person?
Who, the Englewood killer?
Don't you believe in him?
I believe it's just some crazy people out there doing anything just to be famous. Just some copycat fool looking for 15 minutes of fame.
I believe you're right, but to a certain extent. But I know the truth.
And what's that?
That the Englewood killer was not a man.
Excuse me, I'm gonna get that.
Tina, why were you at CMA the other day?
Because it was assigned to me through my job. Why?
But you know he's there. What, did you just want to see him?
Yeah, maybe I did. All right? So what? I wanted to meet the guy that destroyed my family. You know, why do you keep on going there?
Well, I don't go there as much as I used to. But I go there to make sure that that maniac is still there, that he's locked up. He cannot leave that place.
Well, I guess we all have our reasons, now, don't we?
Yeah. So, you believe the story the prophet told you?
As a matter of fact, I do. I'm leaving tomorrow.
Well, Tina, you know I've been a cop for a long time. I've seen a lot, and I've heard even more. And being a good cop, it entails you looking at all of the clues and finding the truth within those clues. Every now and then, you'll throw in a little gut instinct. But we never use feelings. Feelings betray us every time.
Look, I'm gonna go off my feelings, because I was instructed to. If I was to follow that gut instinct you're talking about, my daughter would probably end up on the back of someone's milk carton, or maybe up on the bulletin board at your job. Look, I'm gonna use my fate to find her.
Fate?
Yeah, my fate. You know, at this moment, I really have nothing to lose.
Well, we have to be careful.
We?
Yeah, somehow I feel obligated in some weird kind of way.
Thank you, Paul.
Fine. Herman Webster Mudgett. Yeah, there you go.
In 1886, he turned up on the south side of Chicago, then married a Myrtle Belknap from Wilmette, Illinois. Throughout the marriage, Myrtle Belknap remained living in Wilmette while Mudgett stayed in Chicago. Mudgett. Mudgett who? Although their union produced a son, Myrtle Belknap eventually ended the marriage. Herman Webster Mudgett, tried and convicted, sentenced to death. In the end, he thought his facial features had changed to that of a demon. I was born with the devil in me. I could not help the fact that I was a murderer, no more than a poet can help the inspiration to sing. I was born with the evil one standing as my sponsor beside the bed where I was ushered into the world, and he has been with me ever since.
Step away from the car. Sir, step away from the car.
Lay face down or I will shoot.
I'm afraid, Chris. Do you know where St. Paul's Church is?
Yeah, it's right up the street. Why?
Good. Do you mind if we stop by there before we leave?
I grew up in that church. I want to stop for some prayer if that's okay with you.
You know, I think that's a good idea, Tina.
Excuse me, may I help you?
Hi, Father.
Tina, child, is that really you? Oh, no. Why is it that you weep so? What is ever so wrong?
Father, look, I'm sorry I haven't been to church lately. I've seemed to have lost my faith until now. Look, there's something I need to talk to you about. It's very important. It's a life or death situation. You have to promise me that you keep this between us.
If that is your wish, Tina.
It has to be.
Then how can the Lord's servant be of service to you, my child?
Something's weird about this. Yes, operator. I need a number for Holy Cross Cemetery in Yeatons, Pennsylvania. Okay. 610-555. Gotcha. That's at Yeatons and Bailey Road, correct? Thank you.
Hi, babe. What you up to?
Waiting for my husband to get home so we can pack. Where have you been?
Well, something came up. Something pretty important.
What?
A little girl was kidnapped, and I offered to help her mother find her.
Oh, my God. That's terrible. What's her name?
Tina Moore.
Tina Moore. The name sounds familiar. Isn't that the lady?
Exactly. Exactly.
You are a good man. That's why I love you.
Thanks, Bo.
We'll stay up too late.
Hello, is this Holy Cross Cemetery in Yeaton, Pennsylvania?
Yes. This is Mr. Benjamin Olson, director of the Holy Cross Cemetery. How can I help you?
Mr. Olson, my name is Paul Granberry with the Chicago Police Department. Don't quite know how to say what I gotta say here, but I was looking for a Herman Webster Mudgett. I understand he was buried there.
You are a cop, aren't you? Not a reporter.
Yes, I am with the police department. That's correct.
I don't see why you would lie to me, Mr. Granberry. Mr. Herman Webster Mudgett was moved to another location due to the traffic his history had created here at the cemetery, especially after those books came out.
Do you know where they moved the body?
You would have to ask his daughter-in-law, Miss Mudgett. She lives in Illinois somewhere. I'm not exactly sure where. I can look it up for you, sir.
No, that won't be necessary. Thank you.
Mr. Granberry, may I ask you a question? Why are you looking for the devil?
I'm very sorry to hear from you on such tragic news, Tina. But to answer your question, yes, I've heard about this Inglewood killer. Do I believe he has your daughter? This I cannot say. Do I think you should listen to this lady who is leading you on your search? I cannot mislead or offer you any sense of false hope. The church is not here for that. But if... But if you feel what you're doing is right, then anything is possible.
And this evil one?
The enemy. The enemy has many names and titles. Evil will exist till the end of time. It's inevitable. You can't have good without evil, nor can you have evil without good. Just keep God with you. Trust in your heart and soul. Have faith. And if you truly believe, God will deliver you.
As Mudgy grew, the evil one continuously encouraged the boy to partake in hideous experiments.
Hey, can I join you?
Yeah. This is getting crazy.
What's going on?
Here. Read this.
And in the Southside neighborhood of Inglewood, a serial killer linked by DNA to 6 victims since 1995 has gone largely unnoticed outside the neighborhood he stalks. Like a reoccurring nightmare, he's the third serial killer to plague the 6.5 square mile community of Inglewood since 1991. See, baby, that's why we left the hood. The victims are usually prostitutes and drug abusers, or as police like to call them, women with high-risk lifestyles.
Do you remember Herman Mudgett?
Tell a story every time you get drunk.
Do you remember it?
Yeah, 1975, you arrested a serial killer, Herman Mudgett, while he was dragging 2 bodies.
One of those bodies was Tina's mother.
Oh, dear God.
Read this.
The most enduring supernatural legend of Herman Mudgett is that of the Mudgett Curse. The story began shortly after his execution, leading to speculation that his spirit did not rest in peace. Some believe that he was still carrying on his gruesome work from beyond the grave.
They call him the Inglewood Killer.
Herman Mudgett? The man you arrested?
I think there's some connection between him and Tina's family. He's after him.
If she's connected, then you are too. He's drawn you into him. You're obsessed with him. Baby, please, leave this one alone.
Up. Damn. Tina, look, this is Paul. I just got off the phone with the cemetery in Pennsylvania. Apparently the family moved the body years ago. It's not there. It's possibly here. I'm on my way to Wilmette to talk to Miss Mudgett again. If you get this message, that's where I'll be.
You know, I was told these stories about, like, if you see a demon, right, in the mirror, that means you're marked. Have you ever heard a story like that before?
No. No, I haven't.
But remember to have faith.
You should be careful of people like that. They're hypocrites and evil liars.
Make sure she tells you about the man you saw the other day.
I haven't heard that name in over 25 years, since they took my son away and put him in that awful place.
And if you truly believe, God will deliver you.
Kalila, Tina, Tiny, Tina.
Prince, turn the car around.
What?
Just make this U-turn. Turn the car around.
Okay, but where are we going? Tina, where are we going?
I don't know what it is, but I feel that we need to be in Wilmette, Illinois.
Mudge's house?
Yes, Miss Mudge's house. Damn it. I don't know. Just trust me, all right? Turn the car around. Trust me.
Okay. If you say so.
Shit. You know what? We need to find a payphone. This battery's dead. Listen, Paul, it's me. Look, I need you to meet me at Miss Mudge's house, okay? I'm in Wilmette. I'll tell you everything when we get there, but don't do anything until you see us, okay? Don't move. Move.
Officer Paul Granberry of the Chicago Police Department.
Hello again.
Where's the little girl?
Little girl? Now, why would you think we'd have a little girl here, officer?
What have you done to my legs? I can't feel them.
Oh, they're paralyzed. That's what the drug does to your bones. Permanently. My husband gave me that recipe.
What are you doing? What are you doing with that? What are you gonna do with that knife? Please, lady.
Your pleas fall apart in deaf ears, officer. Just like my pleas when you took my Hermie from me and sent him to that awful place, you selfish!
Look, lady, I got a family. I have a family. Kids, too. Come on.
Do you know who you left me here with? Of course you don't. You don't care. But I'll tell you. Herman Webster Mudgett and Myrtle Belknap fighting and bickering all day long for 30 years. My head has ached for that long. You selfish!
You grew up a white kid! Why a little girl?
One classy. Why a little girl?
13 men buried Herman Webster Mudgett face down, facing hell. Now the descendants of those 13 men are in hell themselves. Yes. Cassie was just next on the list. We only do what we're told, really. Me, my husband, my son, and anyone else Herman decides to take over! We're all his slaves, really.
What are you doing? What are you doing? Leave me alone, you psycho bitch!
And this bitch wants to see your bones!
What are you doing?
Shut up, you selfish!
What are you doing?
Sounds like, oh. Where'd you get that gun?
Don't worry about it.
Huh?
Don't worry about it.
Watch out, she's in here.
What's going on?
I've lost a lot of blood. I'm dizzy.
What's going on? Hello, Tina. Where's my daughter?
Selfish. You'll never see her alive again.
Herman always did have one hell of an imagination.
My daughter. Why are you doing this to me? Just let her go. Why are you doing this?
You selfish. Why, your little girl. Selfish.
Your little girl's great-great-grandfather was one of those selfish men who buried Herman Webster Mudgett face down. So Herman's been back for quite some time now. He's killing the family members of those men who mistreated him. Just like your mother. And now your little girl. You're more than welcome to join them.
Please. Please just bring me back my daughter.
Oh. Sure. Just go get the little bitch.
Where the fuck is Tina? Where the fuck is Tina?
Chris!
Thank you.
So how you feeling, Paul?
Much better now.
You're welcome. That's good. You know, the doctor said she didn't make the drug potent enough.
That's a blessing.
Hey, man, you're a great cop. One of Chicago's finest. I guess I could stop being afraid of you guys so much.
Thanks, man. Hey, sweetie. Oh, so good to have you home.
Excuse me.
Where you going? Tina.
Well, I guess we can go ahead and have that vacation now.
I'm ready when you are.
Listen, I would do anything, anything in this world for you. Is there any way I can repay you?
I get paid enough through God's blessings. This is my job. Wait a minute.
What, is everything okay?
No, Tina, it's not okay.
What is it?
I really hope you're ready for this because this time, you're gonna be on your own.
This can't be true. God, please don't let this be true. No! Oh, God. No! No!
Tina. What is it? Tina! Why are you looking like that? Tina! Tina. What is it? Tina!